Welcome back, everybody. I can't believe another week has gone by so soon. Well, it's time to worship the Lord again and get into the Bible and learn some exciting things there and just have some fun. So let's sing some songs with the band.
I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. He gives me hope for each new day. I'm gonna follow Jesus. He lights my path all along the way. I'm gonna follow Jesus. So I will go wherever he leads. I'm gonna follow Jesus. No turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. He gives me hope for each new day. I'm gonna follow Jesus. He lights my path all along the way. I'm gonna follow Jesus. So I will go wherever he leads. I'm gonna follow Jesus. No turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. No turning back, no turning back. No turning back, no turning back.
Oh, that is great. And again, that's an important declaration to make because we have many stages in our lives, but to say, I am going to purpose to follow Jesus no matter what, so important.
Yeah, it is.
So important. Well, let's sing this next song, Thankful, and remember all the things that God's done in your life.
I like to think about the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just want to lift my hands and say that I love him. I just want to lift my heart in praise. I want to be thankful. I want to be grateful. I want to remember everything the Lord has done. I want to be thankful. I want to be grateful. I want to be. I like to think about the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just want to lift my hands, say that I love him. I just want to lift my heart in praise. And I want to be thankful. I want to be grateful. I want to remember everything that the Lord has done. I want to be thankful. I want to be grateful. I want to be thankful.
wanna be grateful. I wanna remember everything that the Lord has done. I wanna be thankful. I wanna be grateful. I wanna be.
So last week, I wasn't here, but Teacher Joanna was here, and she taught you all about the prophets, didn't she? Let me see. I got a couple review questions for you. Who came first? Not the chicken or the egg. Who came first, the prophets or the kings? Do you remember? Who came first, the prophets or the kings in the order of the Bible? Right, it was the kings. Because remember 2 weeks ago, I talked about the kings and how the children of Israel really wanted a king, so God gave them one, but it didn't work out so good. And then last week, Joanna talked about the prophets. So it was the kings and then the prophets. And what was the job of the prophets? Do you remember what she taught you last week? What was the job of the prophets? Right, they were to tell the children of Israel the messages from God. When God wanted to speak to the children of Israel, he often spoke through the prophets. And my last review question is, were these messages always fun messages to tell them? No, they weren't, were they? And sometimes the prophets, nobody liked the prophets because they always had bad news. But it wasn't always bad news. It was just God was trying to warn them about things. I mean, there was some good news too, and we're going to learn about that this morning. But sometimes they weren't fun messages, so sometimes the prophets weren't always the most liked people. Well, over the last few weeks, we've been telling the story of the Bible. Look, I've got a different Bible this morning. It's still an adventure Bible, but it's an older one, and this one's blue. So we've been telling the story of the Bible, because the whole Bible is one big story. And we started in the very beginning where God created the world. And of course, Adam and Eve sinned, and that became kind of a problem. Then we read about how God purged the earth with the great big flood, didn't he? But he saved Noah and his family. And then he had his own people start out of a family called the children of Israel. And then we talked about Moses, remember, and the burning bush. And we talked about the kings and the failure of the kings and how they were just human and they couldn't really save Israel. And they couldn't be the hero that the people needed them to be. And then, like I said, last week we talked about the prophets, and the prophets predicted a real hero who was going to come and save the children of Israel. And today we're going to talk about that real hero. But before we do, does anybody here like hot sauce? This one is called Simple Hot Sauce, but it's not just simple, it's very, very hot. In my family, all the boys like hot sauce. Rick likes hot sauce so much that when we go to a restaurant and he orders something spicy, like say we go to an East Indian restaurant and he orders curry, he asks them to make it extra hot and spicy. That's how much he likes hot sauce. Can you imagine? Now, Anna and I, the girls in the family, we don't like hot sauce that much. We find it too hot and it kind of, I don't know, burns our mouth or whatever. But if you look in our fridge, you'll find tons of these sauces because everybody likes them. Now, every once in a while, Christopher will say to me, Mom, try this one. You might like it. Try something. And he'll give it to me. And you know what? It burns my tongue. Even a little tiny drop burns my tongue. If I open this hot sauce and I put a little tiny bit on my finger, I'm not going to do it. But if I put a little tiny bit on my finger and I put it on my tongue, it would be too hot because it only takes a little bit of this hot sauce for it to be really spicy. We have this one spice at home, and it's a homemade one that someone made for us, and they took these special peppers called ghost peppers, and they dried them and they ground them into this powder, and you can sprinkle it on your food, and there's actually a warning on the label that says for adults only. Can you imagine? And actually, this hot sauce that I pulled out of the fridge this morning, it's made from ghost peppers too, so it's probably a really, really spicy sauce. Just a little tiny bit is all you need, and you'll taste it all right. Your whole food will taste spicy from the hot sauce. Well, where we ended off in the Bible the last time with the prophets was at the end of the Old Testament. And the people were looking for a hero to save them, weren't they? They were looking for a mighty warrior to come and destroy all their enemies. And when they heard through the prophets that the Messiah was coming, they were so excited. They figured it was going to be a great champion and it would like attack all their enemies. They were really excited. But you know what? The hero that Isaiah and different ones prophesied about that was coming to save Israel came in the form of a tiny baby. No wonder the children of Israel were a little bit confused. They were expecting like almost like a giant to come and save them. And it was a tiny baby was born. But they didn't realize that that tiny baby was like the hot sauce. You only need a tiny baby and he can change the whole world. And hot sauce, we only need a tiny bit and it makes a huge difference. Just because something's small doesn't mean that they can't do anything, does it? Think of the hot sauce. It's the same with you guys. Just because you're young doesn't mean that you can't do anything. You can make a huge difference in the world. Well, Israel had searched for a hero for a long time, and they had different heroes. They had heroes like Samson and Gideon and David, and they had all saved Israel for a time. But the trouble is, they were human. And so they could only defend Israel from their natural enemies, couldn't they? If an army came against them, then David could raise up an army and fight. But they couldn't help the children of Israel with sin, because they weren't sinless. They had sin, and so the only person that could help them fight sin was someone who had never sinned. That's what they needed. And guess what? Jesus is the only one who has never sinned. And so that's why God sent him to the earth as a tiny baby. And he was God, but he was also man because he came in the form of a tiny baby and he never sinned. So Jesus didn't come as the great and mighty warrior that the children of Israel were expecting. He came as a tiny baby. But you know what? Even though they weren't what he was expecting, he was exactly what the world needed. And the story is found in Luke chapter 2. So Luke chapter 2, verses 1 to 20, we often call it the Christmas story, don't we? Because it's all about how Jesus came to the earth. But you know what? It's not only meant for Christmas. It's because it's part of the story. It's part of our story of how God came to the world and died on the cross to save us from sin. So it's part of our story. So we're going to watch just a short video today about the part when the angels appeared to the shepherds and told them that the hero was coming and the mighty warrior was coming, but in the form of a tiny baby. So you watch this just for a minute.
There once were some shepherds who were sitting in a field at nighttime, watching their sheep. An angel came to the shepherds and told them that Jesus was born, that this baby was the one they were waiting for, the one who would save the world. Then so many angels appeared to the shepherds and began singing songs to God. When the angels left, the shepherds went to see what they were talking about. They found the baby Jesus and his parents, Mary and Joseph. They told Mary and Joseph about the angels, and everyone was amazed. Then the shepherds went back to their field, thanking God for everything he had done.
So Jesus didn't stay a baby, of course, did he? He grew up with his brothers and sisters. He learned a trade. He became a carpenter. His family wasn't rich. They were actually kind of poor. And his father, Joseph, and his mom, Mary, he was a carpenter. And like I said, they didn't really have a whole lot. And then he was baptized by his cousin, remember, John the Baptist, and he began his ministry of miracles and teaching people. So Jesus shows us that you don't have to be great, you don't have to be powerful, you don't have to be rich to change the world. You just need to be obedient to what God's asked you to do. And the most humble person can make a huge difference in the world. Well, that's a great message for you to learn at your age, because right now you might be too young for some things. Like, you might be too young to drive. You might be too young to go to university. You might be too young to get to work, to get a job. You might even be too young to go on some of those great big roller coasters. But you know what? You're never too young to serve the Lord. I want you to take your Bible and I want you to turn to a verse, 1 Timothy 4:12. So let's look. 1 Timothy 4, verse 12. This is one of my favorite verses. You know what? When I was a kid, I used to have this on the wall in my bedroom. 1 Timothy 4, verse 12. It says, "Don't let anyone look down on you because you're young, but instead set an example for the believers in speech, conduct, in love, in faith, and in purity." If you don't highlight anything else in your Bible, this is a really good one to highlight. And basically what it's saying is, don't let anyone say to you, "Oh, you're too young." You might be too young to get your driver's license, but when it comes to the things of God, you are never too young. There's always something God can use you to do. You can smile at someone who's having a crappy day. You can, actually, I probably shouldn't say that word, should I? You can smile at someone who's having a bad day. You can make friends with the new kid in school. You can be kind to the teacher that nobody likes. You can, let's see, what else can you do? You can tell your friends about Jesus, or even your family members, or even a stranger, as long as somebody's with you, that Jesus loves them. And you can pray mighty prayers. You can pray prayers that change the world. So you can make a huge impact on the world around you if you let the love of Jesus shine through you. And it doesn't matter how old you are. All right, you ready for a quick review? We're gonna play our true and false game. I got my cards, are you ready? Okay, based on what I told you today, the Messiah came to the earth in a chariot of fire. Is that right? No, that's false. He came as a tiny baby in a manger, didn't he? Imagine that. What about the Messiah grew up in a poor carpenter family, the carpenter and his wife? Is that true or false? Right, that's true, because he was born to Mary and Joseph. What about the only visitor Jesus had when he was born was the innkeeper? Because remember, the innkeeper let them stay in the stable? So was that the only visitor Jesus had? No, that's false. We know that that's false because the shepherds came and visited him on the night he was born, didn't we? Okay, now what about a group of angels announced Jesus' birth to the shepherds? Is that true or false? That's an easy one. That's true, because we know that. And then the shepherds came to visit Jesus. Then the very last question, are you ready for this? Even kids can be used by God to change the world. Is that false or is that true? It's true. Even you can be used by God to change the world. We just need to be obedient and ready to do whatever God asks. So let's pray. Father, I thank you for the kids this morning. I thank you for the call that you have on each one of them. And I thank you that kids can change the world, that you can use them to do mighty things, whether it's through prayer or their actions or whatever. So Father, I pray that the kids would ask you what you want them to do and they would be obedient and do it. So Father, help us to have open and obedient hearts in Jesus' name, amen. Don't forget, you're super important and you can change the world. See you next week.